A major reshuffle at the Philippine House of Representatives as the new Speaker, Lord Allan Velasco, buckles down to work. The reshuffle has also blurred the lines between the majority and minority blocs. Now to discuss the issue, we have with us Bayan Muna Representative Carlos Zarate as we talk about the meeting between the Makabayan bloc and the new Speaker yesterday. Good morning to you, Congressman Zarate.
Good morning, Ms. Karen.
All right, so what was discussed yesterday? Is the Makabayan bloc going to be a part of the majority? Are you remaining to be in the minority bloc, which some believe might go to technically Speaker Cayetano and some former allies?
Well, yesterday, Karen, was a day of meetings for Speaker Lord, no? Lahat ng mga parties nakipag-meet siya from morning until afternoon. Then yesterday afternoon, he met with the minority bloc led by Congressman Benny Abante. No? So nagkaroon ng mga exchanges of ideas. After the meeting with the minority bloc, he requested, no? And also we requested that the members of the Makabayan bloc will remain. No? So again, during that meeting with the Makabayan bloc, he asked for our concerns. We presented to him, tapos we also discussed ano yung mga priority measures niya. And candidly and explicitly, we told him that gusto naming magpaiwan sa minority. No? And we believe that we can be effectively, engage the new leadership if we are in the minority. And we can be fiscalizers, no? We can constructively... Yeah. Collaborate in some measures that we need to be passed, for example, but we will keep our initiatives and independence as a bloc.
Okay, but Congressman Zarate, who is now really the legitimate minority? Where will the allies, for example, of former Speaker Cayetano, who did not vote for Velasco? I saw the list of those who voted for him in the end, but there are some who didn't, like, for example... Deputy Speaker El Rey Villafuerte, who was removed, will he now be part of the minority? How will it work? Because go ahead.
Yeah. Technically, Karen, what happened? There was the position of the speakership was declared vacant, no? At nung mag-nominate ng new speaker, wala namang tumakbong iba. Walang na-nominate na ibang candidate, no? So even based on our rules, ang nagpalit lang talaga ay ang speaker. Mm-mm. At hindi naman nagpalit ang minorya. No? So from the statement of the Speaker Velasco, status quo yan, no? Unless the minority will decide, no? That there will be a change, but as of now there is no such thing that there's a change in the minority. Now what will happen to those who according to you did not vote for Speaker Velasco.
Yeah.
Now, based on our rules, no, they are from the previously from the majority, who are now considered no longer part of the majority. Mm-hmm. So, based on our rules, they have to apply to join the minority. Mm. Hindi automatic yun na sila minority na rin kaagad. Dahil there is a still constituted minority led by. Congressman Benny Abante.
Oo. And at this point, even if they apply, there is no need to vote for a new minority floor leader.
Yes, yes, of course, no. Unless, as I've said, ang ano naman ng Congress is a collegial, even the House, no, even the minority and the majority collegial body, yan, no. So it's for the members to decide. But as of now, we are united in the leadership of Congressman Benny Abante as our minority leader.
So if one of former Speaker Cayetano's top officials want to be minority floor leader, are you telling us now that forget it, it's impossible, the bloc is very united and we are sticking with the present minority floor leader?
Well, ang sabi ko nga, that is for the members to decide, no? But kung tatanungin mo sa minority now, no, I think we are 20 or more or less, no. We are still with the minority leader Benny Abante, no. Mm-hmm. In fact, yesterday when we met with the Speaker Lord Velasco, andoon din si Minority Leader Benny Abante and the rest, and the, some of the members of the Minority Bloc.
Okay. All right. Now, are you expecting more of the same? Both Cayetano and Velasco are technically supporters of President Duterte, right? Yeah. Are you expecting more of the same in the lower house?
Well, there may be differences in some aspect, no? But as I have said in previous...
What are the differences? Perhaps you can describe.
Siguro yung mga priorities nila, no? Yesterday, Speaker Lord mentioned about agriculture, no? And about environment. But basically, kaya nga kami sa minority, and especially the Makabayan Bloc, Ms. Karen, no, ang sabi namin, hindi dapat makikialam dyan sa abayan ng dalawang factions, no? Because this is just part of the continuing war of dominance of the different factions and blocs within the supermajority, no?
Yeah.
Eventually, kahit sino manalo dyan, si Alan pa rin yun, no? What I'm saying is, they are still very much supportive of the legislative agenda of the Duterte administration.
Yes. Except there is a big difference, Congressman, in handling the budget.
Well, yes. When the budget was terminated, no, prematurely, as if I may say, last week, kami yung unang nanawagan na dapat ibalik, no, dahil ang dami pang agencies. Just like kanina, we finished the deliberation of the DENR budget at I think 4:22, no. Dahil nga nagsunod-sunod na yung daming mga ahensya, kailangan ipatong-patong na, no. So we are glad that the new leadership, naging priority nila na buksan uli yung budget, no, dahil ang dami pa talagang dapat i-scrutinize dito, Ms. Karen, especially yung sinabi natin, dapat ang ating focus is the interventions, no, for this problem we are facing now, like itong crisis na aggravated by the COVID-19 pandemic.
Baon.
If I may just cite one example, next year, yung budget natin for vaccine, for example, which has been mentioned several times with the president, is only 2.5 billion. That is not really enough, no, if we want to truly address this problem ng COVID-19.
Okay. Very quickly lang, no, it surprised me when I interviewed Congressman Mikey Romero yesterday that you are still hearing 18 agencies. Tama ito, no, Congressman?
Yes, yes. But so, some are mga maliliit na agencies.
Okay. But if you're still hearing 18 agencies, what did Congress do the past few weeks?
Yeah, dahil nga it was terminated, at least full week yung nawala sa amin. No? Kung sinunod namin yung aming calendar, supposedly last Friday, tapos na kami on second reading. No? And by Wednesday, today, Thursday na ngayon, or even until siguro tomorrow, mag-third reading na kasi mag-printing pa nung General Appropriations Bill. So may 1 week na nalalabas. So yun yung nawala. Kaya... today, major departments, andyan yung DOH, no? Kailangan dinggin pa rin yun. And then tomorrow, there are several other agencies. Yeah. So the target is to finish it until tomorrow, siguro late night.
Okay, because special sessions end tomorrow, October 16, no? I'm correct, it's already tomorrow, it's the last day. And I'm sure the new speaker, this would be the first accomplishment, technically, if he's able to pass it on third reading and transmit the budget by October 16.
Yes. The way I understand it, they will really pass the budget on third reading tomorrow, dahil this is certified as when yung second reading at third reading tomorrow, technically, no?
Mm-hmm.
Kaya talagang kailangan itong mga remaining days ay very crucial, no?
Mm-hmm.
Yung pag-scrutinize natin sa remaining agencies and even the previous ones, no? In fact, we already mentioned some possible amendments to Speaker Velasco, no? Sa mga previous deliberations na pwedeng ma-incorporate na kaagad if kailangan to pass itong third reading tomorrow.
Okay. Another question. What if former Speaker Cayetano wants to be part of the minority? What would you do? Would you accept him as minority?
Rapatan naman ng bawat isa yon, Karen, no? And again, that is a personal decision of former Speaker Cayetano.
But would the minority bloc accept him?
the members should decide on that, no? Walang isang pwedeng mag-decide lang sa issue na yan, Karen, dahil nga collegial body naman kahit ang majority, ang minority. Mm-hmm.
Okay, but then that's the irony of politics in the Philippines and specifically in the lower house. Would minority really mean just because, for example, you lost a position, you lost the speakership? What makes a minority bloc, right?
Yeah, but...
To be a fiscalizer would mean essentially that you are scrutinizing details in the budget, priority measures of this administration.
Well, with the experience of former Speaker Cayetano, of course, probably he's magandang maging kasama rin. He used to be in the previous Congresses, naging part na rin siya ng minority bloc, no?
Yes.
Fiscalizer, no?
But he was clearly criticizing then former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. That's not the case now.
Yes, of course. No, that's why I've said that's the personal decision for. Former Speaker Cayetano. But kami naman, welcome lahat na makakasama. No? Basta ang kampana natin yung ating papel bilang mga mababatas at una sa minorya, pagiging fiscalizer sa loob ng House.
Okay. Huling tanong ko na lang, anong hiningi ninyo ng Makabayan Bloc kay Speaker Velasco?
Well, ang hiningi lang naman namin sa kanya, no? Sa Bloc, Makabayan Bloc, ma-maintain yung aming... initiatives and independence as a bloc, no, even if you are part of the minority. Tapos yung mga cons ng mga advocacies and concerns namin na pakikinggan, no? Magkakaroon ng constructive engagement, especially with the new leadership, na yun naman din ang ginagawa namin even in the previous congresses.
Mr. And as a bloc, you did not vote?
Yeah, we did not, no? We did not. Ang stand namin, yan yung bangayan sa loob ng supermajority coalition at hindi dapat nakikialam, especially kami sa Makabayan.
All right. On that note, thank you very much, Congressman Carlos Zarate, for joining me this morning. One last question. I'm quite curious. You've always spoken against the rejection of the ABS-CBN franchise. And are you seeing changes right now in the landscape in Congress with a new speakership?
Well, I will not discount that possibility, but at the end of the day, Ms. Karen, alam naman po natin kung sinong may kumpas talaga, no, pagdating specifically sa usapin ng franchise ng ABS-CBN. Nasa Malacañang talaga yan, no? And there is nothing bad in hoping, but we have to be realistic also pagdating sa usapin na yan, especially with what happened previously, no, under the previous administration sa House.
Okay. And while you're hearing right now, one of the agencies you're hearing, I know before we go, is the budget of the DENR. And you have called, I think in yesterday's hearing, that the statements of DENR Yusek Antiporda, we'll be having him later on the show, that he be reprimanded for actually calling UP Bayaran.
Yes. Not yesterday, just this morning, Karen. Kasi natapos ko my interpellation 4:22 a.m. na, no? And I closed the debate. Mm-mm. Yes, because I think that is uncalled for, no? For an official like Yusek Benny, na parang napaka may aversion siya for constructive criticism, no? Hindi nga batikos yung ginawa ng UP. They were just proposing mga long-term solutions dyan sa problema sa Manila Bay. Ganun na lang tatawagin niya, mga bayaran kayo, wala kayong nagawang infrastructure, no? That's why I told the sponsor and Secretary Simato, no, na in fact reprimanding him is not enough, no? He should apologize publicly to the UP community, especially sa ating mga siyentista at mga kawalin ng agham, Ms.
Oo. Okay, tanong ko lang, if Yusek Benny Antiporda does not apologize publicly, will the budget of the DENR hang in the balance? Because we've seen how you all as a group demanded that with PCS, PCOO, that Lorraine Badoy actually resign. And she's taken a hard line on that too.
Yes. But technically, yes, Karen, technically, yung... deliberation sa budget ng DENR terminated na, no? Or as the committee on appropriations is concerned, tapos na yon. So ang nakuha na lang nating commitment from Secretary Simato that they will resolve this problem, no? And hopefully we will learn a lesson from this one, no? Na dapat hindi naman tayo balak sibuyas at hindi ganun tayo maka sabi na lang na mga bayaran kayo, no?
Did Secretary Simato tell you early this morning that Yusek Antiporda will apologize publicly?
He did not categorically state that, no? But he said that it was a mistake and it was wrong, at least through the sponsor. No? Kaya sabi ko nga, if it was already admitted that it was a mistake and it was wrongful, then reprimand is not enough. No? Kailangan mag-apologize dahil ang nasira, the reputation that is besmirched here are not only that of a particular agency, no? At ang buong, I think, buong scientific community, no? Sinasabi, especially yung ating mga nasa gobyerno na scientific community, na hindi kayo dapat bayaran, libre kayo, mga bayaran kayo. I think that is really not acceptable, Ms. Carlos.
All right. Thank you so much, Congressman Carlos Zarate, for your time this morning. We'll see if DENR Undersecretary Benny Antiporda heeds your request. Thank you so much, sir.